creators, great to have you back here at Monzon Media. Today I'm going to show you how to create this countdown timer in Canva from scratch. Click on the video icon here on the homepage, or alternatively, you could create a new design and select video. And once you're in the workspace, you want to stay in templates and choose a background. Now this particular one I'm using, I just searched in Elements for Tech. This one's called Yellow Magenta Black White Neon Sci-Fi YouTube Intro. That's a mouthful. Otherwise, you can search for tech or anything that you want to use for a particular look. So once you've selected that, you can import it into your workspace. And we're going to delete the text and the other objects. I'm going to keep these lines, these animated lines, and change the colors. And of course, you could change the colors to your liking. Now what we're going to do, I'm going to explain this as we go, but you're going to see that this particular clip lasts 30 seconds, so it's a continuous motion, okay? We're going to trim it to 2 seconds per clip, and I'm going to show you why we do that, because what we want to do is create a seamless look in the background as opposed to just a repetition of the same motion. So set that to 2 seconds. Once that's complete, go into Elements and we're gonna look for a neon circle, and that's what I searched for in the search field. Now it's up to you if you want to use a static one or an animated one. Just choose something that you'd like to use. I chose this particular one. And once you import it into your workspace, hold onto Alt as you drag it so that you can increase the size or decrease the size while keeping it centered. Or alternatively, you could go up to the top and click on the position to make sure it's in the middle and centered. Next, what we want to do is select an animation. So while it's selected, click on Animate, and this particular one I used Stomp, but if you're on the free version, you can use any of the free ones like Rise. Breathe is nice too because it's got that, you know, zooming in look. But for the Canva Pro users, I used Stomp. You can use Neon or Pop or any one of the other ones. Next, we just have to bring in the numbers in, so go to the left and select text and choose a font that you prefer to use. We're going to go ahead and put in number 1 here. Now for this particular example, I used League Spartan for the font. Now we're going to assign some effects and animate this. Oh, actually, this is a countdown timer from 10. So I need to change this to 10. So let me do that first. Now while your number is selected, head over to the top menu where your options are and give it a color of your choice. You could use the neon circle colors if you wanted to, but I'm gonna choose this blue color and give it a neon effect. Feel free to use any of the other effects that you like. And for the animation, we're going to choose roll to get that, rolling effect. And this is pretty much the setup process. And what we're going to do is repeat this for all the other numbers. However, there is one little minor tweak we have to do to the background. So next, what we're going to do is increase the thumbnail icon. So click on this little icon here, and you have two options here. One is to zoom the page. Click it again, you have zoom thumbnails. We're just going to increase the length of these thumbnails, and click on the three dots on the top right corner of the first clip, and we're going to select duplicate. Now before we carry on, I'm going to show you why we're going to do the next steps. So I'm going to change this number to 9. Now let's preview this, and I want you to pay attention to the background, and you're going to see that it's not a very smooth transition, and you see that the background just repeats itself from the same position. We don't want that. We want the background to continue its movement and motion and look seamless. So the first thing we're going to do is clip on the new clip and trim the clip starting from 2.1 seconds to 4.1 seconds. So remember I said each clip's going to be 2 seconds. So what we're doing is we're continuing that motion in the background there so that it looks more seamless. And of course, for the other numbers, we're going to repeat that same process. But for the number 8, we're going to start at 4.1 to 6.1. To make this more seamless, this is where the video editor really comes in handy, especially the transitions. We're going to click on that plus button there and add transition. We're going to choose dissolve and change the timing to 0.2 seconds. So in between the clips, it's going to kind of, you know, merge or morph the two clips together with a gentle dissolve so that you can barely see the transition. So again, look at the background and look how almost seamless it is. You could see it now. If I wanted it more seamless, I'd use 0.1 seconds, but I think 0.2 does the job there. It's really up to you. So all that's left to do to complete this is to rinse and repeat the same process. Now, whether you want to use audio or not, that's up to you. And really, all you have to do is go to the left menu, select audio. For the preview, I used this really edgy metal sounding track called Inner Eclipse. So as we look at the final result, as you can see, it's super simple to do. Now, if you wanted to create a longer countdown timer, like 2 minutes or 1 minute, you can follow the same steps. It's just a bit more tedious because you got more numbers to do. As always, folks, thanks for coming by to visit. I hope you got value out of this video. And of course, until the next video, I'll see ya when I see ya.